Let's continue with the damping discussion, and then I will go to e-tabs to show you some of the options. I will skip all these details. So we know already that we have this equation of motion, the complete equation with damping, and it can be non-linear also, it can be linear also. The K matrix can be straight away formulated from the structural elements, their geometry, materials, and other properties. But C matrix cannot be directly formulated. We have to have a model for C matrix in order to construct it. So there can be two important damping models. One is the modal damping, other is the mass and stiffness proportional damping or the Rayleigh damping. There is another damping which is Kali damping model, this one. That I will not discuss. I will discuss only these first two. Because these two are available readily in ETABS or SAP or in Perform 3D also. So let's first discuss the modal damping. The modal damping. In modal damping, what you do is, as I have explained earlier also, that you assume that each mode shape will have a particular damping ratio, xi I, such that this whole term phi transpose into C into phi will have only diagonal values, and diagonal values are these ones. 2 into xi into omega into modal mass into velocity. So what you can do is that you can construct back from this idea that you already have this term in the modal equations. You can construct back the C matrix, and that C matrix will be your modal damping matrix. So the equation of motion for each mode is already assumed with the damping term now. And this xi I now represents the lumped quantity of energy dissipation for each mode, for any ith mode now. So if we call that phi transpose into C into phi, that matrix, let's call it as D. So the D matrix will be this one, that it will only have the diagonal entries, all off diagonal terms will be zero. So we can transform back from D back to C, and that C will be your damping matrix now. So let's convert D into C. I will skip these details because they are already explained in the main lecture. But what we can do is simply, we can use this final expression, this one, to transform this D matrix again to the original damping matrix C, where this D prime is basically this one. All you need to know is the modal damping for each mode, xi I. You need to know the mu I for each mode. You need to know the omega I for each mode. If you know these quantities, you can construct the D prime matrix. You have already the phi transpose, you already have the mass matrix. This is also the mass matrix, this is the phi matrix. So finally, you can carry out this product to calculate the C matrix. If you calculate C matrix using this idea, this will be called modal damping. Because what you did is that you assumed a modal damping for each mode and constructed the D matrix or D prime matrix and then converted back to the C matrix. So now this, how to come up with this xi I for each mode? There are different tables or guidelines available in literature, which guides you that if you have a structure of this kind, you should use this much damping ratio. For example, such kind of a table that you have a type of the structure and you have the guideline for damping ratio. Generally, for typical buildings, code prescribed a damping ratio of 5% for all important vibration modes. So xi I is generally 5%. But for high-rise buildings, this number can be less than 5%, can be 2% or 2.5%. For steel structures, this number can also be even less. So you rely on these guidelines, similar kind of tables, I will skip all that detail, to estimate xi I, and then using xi I, you construct the C matrix. So this is one approach for constructing C matrix. This is called modal damping. This is also available in ETABS, and I will directly show you after this demonstration. The second option is Rayleigh damping. Rayleigh damping approach is the one in which we write C matrix as a function of mass matrix and K matrix. Since mass and K matrix are already, the mode shapes are already orthogonal to each other with respect to M and K. So if we combine M and K in some proportions and add them to construct the C matrix, that C matrix will also be resulting in a classical damping, which means mode shapes will also be orthogonal to with respect to that C matrix. So how we can do that in this approach? That we have first two ideas, which one is called the mass proportional damping, other is called the stiffness proportional damping. These two ideas says that you can simply write the C matrix as some constant number multiplied by the mass matrix. That constant number can be set such that the resulting product of these two numbers and matrix will correspond to the amount of real energy dissipation in your structure. Similarly, this idea says, this stiffness proportional damping, that you can multiply one number, one constant number with K matrix to construct the C matrix. And that constant number basically can be tuned such that that your C matrix constructed is a representative of the actual energy dissipation in the computer model. These two ideas are explained in a form of a figure like this, that if you have the mass proportional damping, it is equivalent to having a one, you can say, energy dissipating device or a damper wherever there is mass is lumped. So whenever there is M1, M2 and M3, there will be three dampers applied to those masses. Each will have the same constant A naught into M1, A naught into M2, A naught into M3. A naught can be set such that this dampers represent the real amount of energy dissipation. How we can set this A naught? Because we know already that for any nth mode, we know that the damping constant C is equal to 2, C is basically equal to 2 m omega xi. So you can write the same equation for a single degree of freedom system for an nth mode also. In that case, Cn will become 2 into mass will become modal mass, which is denoted as mu or m here. M or mu is same, into omega, and then xi. N will be mode, and everything will have n at its subscript. So from here, xi can be written as Cn over 2 omega into modal mass, and let's be consistent. So let's call this as Mn, but Mn is same as mu because it is the product of this phi n transpose into m into phi. So this is the diagonal element of this phi transpose into m into phi. So this Mn basically is same as phi, mu. So now what we can do is that we know already that Cn is equal to A into M, because damping constant for an nth mode is proportional to the nth mode mass. Nth mode mass is phi n transpose into M into phi n, and A naught is there. So we can, we already know that C basically is equal to 2 mu or Mn basically omega n into xi n. So we can equate these two equations, and we can calculate this xi n, and we can also calculate this A naught. A naught will be 2 into xi n into omega n. So for example, for an nth mode, I want to give a damping ratio of 5%. So what I can do is that I can put here xi n equal to 5%, and omega n for that mode is already given. So A naught can be calculated. And finally, A naught is there, so can be multiplied with the mass matrix to construct the C matrix. So that's how the idea of mass proportional damping can work. that you have to calculate or give a constant called a naught, sometimes also called as alpha, and its value is 2 into xi into omega, and you have to select which xi you want to give to which mode. So for example, for first mode you want to give 5%, so you pick, you put this as 5%, you put this one as the frequency of the first mode, and you get the a naught. But you cannot control the damping assigned to other modes using this idea, only for one mode, because the same constant a naught will be applied for all the story masses to calculate the damping matrix. The idea of stiffness proportional damping is also similar. In that case, I will skip all that detail, but directly tell you what will be a in that case. A will be basically 2 into xi into omega, in this case also, here you can see. And this will be A1 now, not A naught, because this is the stiffness proportional damping. So if A1 is set such that a particular damping ratio is assigned to your particular vibration mode, you can calculate A1 and put it here, and C matrix will be constructed. And again, you will have control over only one mode's natural this damping ratio. You cannot control the damping ratio of more than one mode's. But if you combine the idea of mass proportional and stiffness proportional dampings using what we call as the Rayleigh damping approach, in which the C matrix is constructed as this: A0 into M plus A1 into K. Now you have to give the A0 and A1 to the software, and it will all automatically calculate C matrix using this expression. It will combine M and K after multiplying it with A0 and A1 to construct the C matrix. So I will skip all this detail because I have explained it in the online lecture. The final thing is that this is the set of expressions which are required to calculate A naught and A1. So for example, if you have two, you can say frequencies, omega i and omega j, you can use these two set of equations to calculate A naught and A1. And you can set the same damping ratio for both of these, omega I and omega j. Omega I is, let's say, ith mode. Omega j is, let's say, for the jth mode. Let's say it is the first mode, and let's say it's the fifth mode. And let's say you want to set the damping ratio of first and fifth mode as 5%. So what you can do is that you can put this xi equal to 5%. And omega I and omega j you can set for first mode and fifth mode. You already know these two numbers. So you can calculate A naught and A1, and these two coefficients you have to provide in the software. So basically what you are doing is that you are controlling the damping assigned to the first mode to 5%. Let's say this is the damping on y-axis. And the second mode also will be having the damping equal to 5%. Same damping. So in between them, the damping will be quite close to 5%, but you cannot control it beyond fifth mode or whatever is the omega j. So the curve basically, which is the curve of these equations, will shoot maybe up. So the idea is that for all the significant vibration modes for which you want to assign the damping, you can set omega I and omega j such that all the significant vibration modes are in between this range, and they will be given this damping which you desire. For all other modes, you don't need to control the damping for higher vibration modes. So the graphical form which I've already shown is, if xi is on y-axis here, xi n, then you have omega I and omega j for which you have the same damping ratio. You control these two points using A0 and A1, And for in between that, the damping will be slightly less than 5%, but similar close to that. Before omega I and after omega j, the lines will go up, and you don't need to control these modes dampings because they will not significantly contribute towards the response of your structure. So you have to select this omega I and omega j such that all significant vibration modes are in between these range. So maybe first five modes for a building. So five modes means that this should be the frequency of first mode. This frequency should be the frequency of fifth mode. So with this information, let's go to ETABS now and see these two options, modal damping and Rayleigh damping in ETABS. And it will be in the same dynamic load case, by the way. So let me go to define load cases. And now I add a new load case, which is the dynamic load case. And in that dynamic load case, we have to define whether we are using modal damping or Rayleigh damping. If modal damping, then what is the modal damping ratio for each mode? If Rayleigh damping, then what are the coefficients A0 and A1? So let me go to the time history. And then I go to, let's say, both of the options, I can use linear modal or linear direct integration. Let's say I go for direct integration. And here at the end, you can see here this damping option here. So I modify this one and I go into this dialog box. And here I can see that I am given with these three options for viscous proportional damping. One is the direct specification. This is basically Rayleigh damping. And mass proportional coefficient, which is A0, and the stiffness proportional coefficient A1 should be provided here. The second option in the viscous proportional damping is the specify damping by period. In that case, what you can do is that you, instead of directly specifying the coefficients, you define that at what period you want to assign what damping. So 2 points you can control, because the formulation of Rayleigh damping is such that you can control 2 points. So let's say I say that at 1 second time period, whatever the mode is at 1 second, I want to give it as 0.05, which means 5%. And at 0.1 seconds, I want to give the same number 0.05. And then if I recalculate coefficients, you can see here the coefficients are now automatically calculated, A0 and A1, which will fit this criteria that at these two time periods, the dampings will be these two numbers. The third option is specify damping by frequency. Instead of applying the damping values or calculating the coefficients for period versus damping, you can also do it for frequency versus damping. So if you change, for example, 2 hertz to 10 hertz should have the damping between 0.5 to 0.5%. If you recalculate, the coefficients will be recalculated here. And if you click OK without doing anything, what you are doing essentially is that you are using the Rayleigh damping. However, you also have the additional modal damping option here in the bottom. So if I click OK, let's say first, you can see here that mass, this coefficient, stiffness, this coefficient, modal, no. But if I modify it again and I say that, OK, I want to include the modal damping also, the second damping option. In that case, you first have to select that your mode shapes, which will be used in calculating the C matrix, should come from which load case, which modal case. The default modal case is called modal in ETABS, and that is by default selected. I will go to this modify show modal damping parameters. And here you can give the xi I for each mode. Again, you have three options. One is the constant damping for all modes. In that case, whatever number you provide here, it will be xi I for each I, for each mode. The second option is interpolated damping by period or frequency. In that case, you will have time period or frequency column and the damping column. So you will say, okay, at this time period, the damping should be this. At the other time period, the damping should be some other number. So you can add different numbers. For example, for time period 1, you should have a damping ratio of 0.05. At time period equal to, let's say, 2 seconds, you will have a damping of, let's say, 0.06. For example, you can add as many numbers as you want. In period versus time, period versus damping, or frequency versus damping, if you click on this option, interpolated by frequency. So for example, if your first mode is in between 0.5 seconds and 1 second, or let's say 1 second and 2 seconds, if your first mode is in between them, the software will automatically interpolate the damping ratio for that particular mode from these two numbers. And the third option here in modal damping is the mass and stiffness proportional damping by coefficient. And that is similar to the proportional damping which we have seen in the previous dialog box. So here again, if I select the third option, there will be three further options: that you directly specify the coefficients A0 and A1, or you specify the modal damping by giving the time period and the corresponding damping, or giving the frequency and the corresponding damping, and the coefficients will be recalculated according to your given damping for that particular range. So for example, if I give 0.05 and 0.05 and recalculate, the coefficients will be calculated automatically. So if you click OK, in that case, you have defined both the proportional damping as well as the modal damping. So it's your choice, whatever you want to use. The common practice is that you use modal damping to control the damping ratio for all significant vibration modes according to whatever number you want to set. But for higher modes, you also set a very small number of viscous proportional damping, which is the Rayleigh damping, because that other modes other than the ones which you want to control by modal damping, other modes will have very high damping and they will be suppressed, and the numerical errors will not be occurred in your solution of ETABS. So you can click now. If I click OK, I will have both mass proportional damping as well as modal damping. So that's how, with using this option, you can give the necessary inputs to the software so that it can construct the C matrix using either the proportional damping or the modal damping. So I hope that this demonstration will make you clear about what damping, or how the software basically calculates C matrix. So both of these models will result in classical damping, and you can use them with the idea of modal response history analysis, which is linear modal in this case. Time history and linear modal will still have modal damping here. These options are still here. So you can use modal damping, or you can also use the proportional damping. So I hope that it is clear now. If you have any questions or clarifications, you can ask now.